여러분 안녕하세요. 자, in this video, let's take a look at the conversation 2 of lesson 3. 오늘 수업 있으세요? 오늘 today 수업 class 있으세요? So in this case, this means do you have well, that kind of meaning. So do you have class today? 그렇죠. 오늘 수업 있으세요? Jenny asks Michael. Michael 씨, 오늘 수업 있으세요? 그렇죠. You can add the subject particle here too. 오늘 수업이 있으세요? 그렇죠. 수업이 있으세요? 자, so we practiced this structure. Something이 or 가, 뭐 certain place에 있어요. 뭐 in conversation one. So when there is a location marked with 에 and followed by 있다, 없다, then it means something is located at certain place. But if there is no location information in a sentence with 있다, then generally it means well, there is something or someone has something, well, that kind of meaning. So when you see a sentence with 있다 or 없다, please check if a place is marked. Then it means something is located at a certain place. If there is no place marking, that it means there is something or someone has something. So in this case, Michael 씨, 오늘 수업 있으세요? Today class exists. Do you have class? Are there classes today? 뭐 that kind of meaning 그래요. 그래서 something이 가 있다 is generally understood as 뭐 possessive meaning. So do you have something? 뭐 I have something. 저는 수업이 있어요. I have 뭐 classes. 그렇죠. So Michael 씨 오늘 수업 있으세요? Do you have class today? Michael answers 네. 한국어 수업이 있어요. So Korean class 뭐 exist 그렇죠? 그래서 I have a Korean class. 뭐 there is a Korean class. 뭐 that kind of meaning. 제니 씨는요? So Michael wants to ask Jenny the same question. 제니 씨는 오늘 수업 있으세요? So when you want to ask the same question, you can just say like this. Somebody는요? 그럼 how about you, Jenny? 그렇죠? Jenny says 오늘은 수업이 없어요. 그렇죠? So opposite word to 있어요 is 없어요. 그렇죠? So today there's no class. Today I have no class. 그렇죠? 그런데 so 그런데 is a conjunction that has the meaning something like but or by the way 그래요. So it's depending on the context it can be something like but or by the way. By the way, 내일은 경제학 수업이 있어요. 뭐 but tomorrow 경제학 수업 그러면 economics class 있어요. 그렇죠? So there is an economics class. 한국어 수업은 재미있어요. 그렇죠? So Korean class 재미있어요. 재미있다 to be fun, interesting. So is the Korean class fun? 뭐 이런 거죠? Michael says 네, yes. 아주 재미있어요. 뭐 한국어 수업은 아주 재미있어요. 그렇죠? 아주 뭐 very 그렇죠? 그리고 and so after a sentence we use 그리고 그렇죠? 그리고 선생님도 좋으세요. Actually the basic sentence should be 선생님이 좋으세요. 근데 Michael already mentioned that Korean class is fun and he is adding more information why 뭐 he likes this class. So 선생님 this noun also teacher also good 그렇죠 좋으세요. 그래서 it's something like 뭐 so 뭐 therefore 뭐 that kind of conjunction. So 매일 열심히 한국어를 공부해요. 매일 every day 열심히 공부하다 그러면 study hard 그렇거든요. 그래서 열심히 this adverb is generally used with 공부하다 to mean study hard 그렇죠. 열심히 한국어를 공부해요. So every day I study Korean hard 그렇죠. Jenny asks 한국어 교실은 어디 있어요? So 한국어 교실, 교실은 classroom 그렇죠? So Korean classroom 어디 있어요? So 어디 있어요? So you may already know this structure. So where is the Korean classroom 그렇죠? 로이스 홀 3층에 있어요. So this is the location followed by this 에. In that case, 있어요 is used to express the location of something. 그렇죠? 그래서 한국어 교실은 로이스 홀 3층에 있어요. So Korean classroom is located on the third floor of 로이스 홀. 그렇죠? 자, so we have learned two functions of 있어요. So when 있어요 is used with location information followed by 에, then 있어요 is used to express the location of something. When there is no such thing, something 이 있어요, then it simply means there is something or somebody has something, that kind of meaning. So they are kind of confusing, but if you keep practicing, you'll be able to distinguish them naturally. 자, 그러면 여러분, 감사합니다.